Allora, prof, che racconti? What's up, big man?
Hello, hello, hello.
What's up, what's up, what's up? Chilling, man, how about you? Oh, I think the last time I left the house was last week. Or you said that to him, right?
Yeah.
No, it's good, man. Mario was in the very first...
The first independent filmmaking master.
At NYU.
Now nobody knows Antonio.
Did I tell you when I was in Mexico City that I saw the Rossellini film? Germania anno zero, Deutschland ja null. Sì, 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 ha fatto bene. Che l'ha fatta, è stata quella serie che ha fatto con Roma Città Aperta.
But I wasn't a writer, so they told me to do directing, which and after the guy said you are not, I was 45,
mm-hmm.
So they said you should do acting and work and make money.
Okay, okay.
That's why they sent me to all acting. So my teacher, which was the actor studio guy, he said he brought me to the actor studio to meet everybody, you know, Robert De Niro, Robert Redford, all these guys. And after that, they sent me to teach assistant acting and directing in Maine. And
okay.
I was working with in a new movie.
Okay.
With a guy from what's his name, the Australian actor, the famous one.
Which one? Russell Crowe or Mel Gibson?
Mel Gibson.
Okay. And then what was the film that you were on with Al Pacino?
That was Carlito's Way.
Carlito's Way. Okay. It would have been The Sopranos, right? Would have been the show.
Well, I got the part in The Sopranos for the killer guy. I didn't have a green card, and I sent it from New York University. I sent another friend.
Okay.
And he got the part.
And he got the part instead.
Yeah, I called the actor who died, what's his name?
Gandolfini. Okay.
I said, I'm sorry, because he was Italian. So I said, I'm sorry. The lawyer says to me, don't do it, because I was using fake name. And I said to this guy, he got the part. This guy, I told him, didn't offer me not even a coffee or lunch. You know, it was a billionaire, Federico. You have a foreign language, you can work everywhere.
Yes.
You can work in 3 days. You go there, say, oh, good morning. You tell the good morning in 5 languages, and
that's
say,
it. And so Mario was.
Guten Tag.
Guten Tag. Yeah, that's it. In Germany, that's all you need. Okay.
Thank you. Ciao, guys.
Bye. Grazie a te, Mario.
Go to the gym.
Go to the gym.
What's his name?
Kijin.
See you soon.
So you guys, did you see Mario? That's my friend, he's from Umbria, and he's an actor and a writer. He's just all around a great character. And he's taught me a lot. He's taught me a lot about performing and a lot about thinking about the mind of an actor and sort of character development and the many, many different shades of a character. Oh. What a beautiful day, man. Mario is such a character, and he's got a lot of charisma. He is a very good actor, and he has such an incredible face, a very Italian face, you know. I don't have a very Italian face necessarily. So Kijin told me about this these noodles that you see in Parasite, and I love that film, Parasite. I thought it was such a great, it was a close to flawless movie. My only qualm with that film actually is the very ending of it. So after the scene where the father, you know, kills the other father, you know, after that scene and he's running downstairs and he goes into the basement, I think that's where the film should have ended. And so that whole, let's call it the postscript, where the son wakes up in the hospital, you know, hysterically, and then all of his little fantasy of being up in the woods and imagining buying back the house so they can get their dad back. It's such a good film that it's a small complaint. I mean, it still works fantastically with that, and obviously it won all the awards, so I'm not sure what do I know, but I would have cut it there right after the dad runs downstairs and goes into the basement. That's where I would have ended it. I think it would have been a stronger ending. But anyways, I'm very excited to try these noodles. Chapaguri. Chapaguri. I'm gonna try to remember that. Chapaguri. 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 Let me try to remember. Chapaguri. Chapaguri. Doesn't sound like carbonara, but I'm sure it'll be good. Chapaguri. 32nd Street. It's funny, when I first moved here, man, I stayed in a hotel right close to here when I first moved to New York. So for the first 4 or 5 days that I was here, I was always going to the street to eat. So unfortunately, Kijin was mistaken. We couldn't find any chapaguri in Koreatown. So instead, we've come to Miss Korea, and we're gonna try some pork belly barbecue. Because I've had Korean barbecue before, but I've never had pork. This is delicious. Okay. Kimchi marigutsu. Here we go. So you promise this isn't too spicy, man?
Master, master, master.
We'll have to have chapaguri another time. Maybe in Korea.